So it's that time of year again, guys. Lent. Lent is rolling around. And, you know, I've kind of half-assed it over the last couple years. But this year, I'm going to do my best going all in. I'm trying to give up Tinder.
Is anything going to change?
Nothing's going to change. So with the rules I made for myself are I can go on the app. I can see, like, if I get a notification that someone messaged me or someone, like, I got a new match, I can check the message. I can check the match. I can't swipe, and I can't send a message or, like, reply to a message. I can't actually use it at all.
So what I'm hearing is you're going to go from one match a month to zero.
Well, I mean, I'll still get the... I mean, I swiped a lot before Ash Wednesday. Like, a lot.
Set yourself up for success.
Set myself up for the month.
My favorite part of Lent is Ash Wednesday, because you see all the good Catholic people walking around with the fucking... with the ashes.
I haven't got the ashes in years, but I still practice Lent.
All right, well, we're doing a rare fucked up episode, so cheers, everyone. Baby.
What's up, guys? Welcome to the Plunge. Today is a day. We're all in person today. Woo! Shout out to Ice Den.
Shout out Ice Den.
Shout out Ice Den.
Joining us, as always, is Riley T and Devious Dave. Say what's up, guys.
Loosely, as always, but yes, hello, everyone.
We're here.
0-7.
and special guest, College Timmy. Frat Star Timmy, excuse me.
Frat Star Timmy. Golden Greek.
What frat are you in?
He's a Sammy.
Sammy.
You actually
know what that is.
I don't know. Historically Jewish, which is pretty funny. Nice.
So you guys save a lot of money.
Our finances are garbage.
I'm your host, GB. This is The Plunge. I got to get that in there. You need to know who I am.
Just so people don't know. Yeah.
Brought to you from the Inner Circle Podcast Network. You can check out many of our friends and great shows, our teammates on the Inner Circle.
At Inner Circle
PN.
PN.
Yeah. You can find the likes of hashtag SamPC.
Shit happens when you party naked.
HTNOS.
And the Hood Diner Podcast.
The Hood Diner Podcast. That name just sticks out to me when we say all these. The Hood Diner. Go you guys.
Yummy. Shout out. This episode of The Plunge is also brought to you by Adam and Eve. Are you looking to spice things up in the bedroom?
Yes.
Been fantasizing about surprising your lover with an adventurous new toy or adult movie?
Lovers don't exist, but yes.
I was just about to say that.
I know you were. I said it first.
Well, here's an offer you won't be able to resist. Go to adamandeve.com.
Where?
Adamandeve.com.
Okay.
For a limited time only. And you'll get 50% off. That is 50% off.
Not 48. Not 49.
Not 51.
Not 37.
50% off just about any item.
Any item.
But that's not all.
Don't tell me it's not all.
Not all. When you select your one item at 50% off, you'll also receive, wait for it.
Okay, I'm waiting.
Three free adult movies. Star Wars 7, Star Wars 1, and Lord of the Rings 2.
And Solo, A Star Wars Story.
Only three. Chill out.
Wait, they're not dirty movies?
Free adult movies.
Star Wars is an adult movie.
For a little inspiration. Plus, a free extra gift. So sensual.
So sensual.
We can't even mention it on the airwaves.
Do it anyways.
No.
Is it anyways or anyway? Anyway, back to
the And show. To top it all off, they're also going to throw in free shipping.
Free shipping.
Those pesky shippings, they get you. They're like, oh, here's our $4.99 item, but oh, you got to pay $5.99? Not on adamandeve.com, promo code PLUNGE. That is free shipping your entire order. And no, they're not kidding.
Not even a little bit.
Not even one bit.
Maybe somewhat.
No.
Okay, no.
So,
is it dead serious?
Check out adamandeve.com today for this special offer. Get 50% off your one item when you type plunge, that's PLUNGE, for the offer code upon checkout.
That's 50% off.
50 with a percent symbol behind it.
And when you do, you'll get 3 free DVDs, a free extra gift, and free shipping. Just use offer code plunge at adamandeve.com. That is PLUNGE at adamandeve.com. Hunter, what is our Adam and Eve product of the week?
It is the 8-inch All-American Whopper Dong.
This thing is massive, ladies and gentlemen. I have never seen anything like it.
For your most realistic sexual approach, please pick the 8-inch All-American Whopper Dong. It is raving reviews. 5 stars. Perfect Whopper. Of all the toys that we have tried in the past, finally, this one is the best. And orgasm after orgasm. Oh, this is the best thing bought this year. The suction is amazing. So if you are looking for an 8-inch All-American Whopper dick...
with suction.
Hit up adamandeve.com. Promo code PLUNGE for 50% out on checkout. Excuse me.
How much is the 8-inch Whopper Dong?
It is $34.95.
Well, you know what that means? That means it's $17.50 with promo code PLUNGE and 6 free items. Can you believe it?
We know math, people.
Yeah.
Riley knows math.
Yeah, that took me a second to figure out. I was like, I'm going to
check. I still am trying to do the math.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it on my calculator right now just to double check.
I think there's a 48.5 cents in there somewhere.
Hunter, you owe $10 to the... We have a debt. We have our charity bin. We're all paid off. You have a debt right now because you're broke.
No, I'm not broke. I'm just going to say I have an unofficial... I put in an unofficial $1.50 and Davis hit me up with the 50 cents of the dollar that he owed.
You're welcome.
I personally just went out, grabbed all the stuff in my change compartment, which was it was like a fistful of change.
There's also an empty jewel pod and a condom now in the change jar.
Empty jewel pod. The condom has been in there for, I want to say, like 6 months.
It's probably expired. Like, so you can't even donate that
there
to
was
people.
A girl
are we giving that to the special needs children?
Yeah, everything in there is going to, what is it?
The Special Olympics of New Hampshire.
Yeah, so...
So you still owe $10.
So,
I just want you to know.
I fully expect you to bleep this out. The special kids can get their fuck on.
I'm not bleeping that out. I want the special kids to get their fuck on. Create more special kids.
And you know where they can do it? You know where they can start?
AdamandEve.com! They can use Spunk Lube.
Official lube of the podcast.
The official
lube
of podcast.
Hey, drink it. Never mind, there's some crusty stuff on there. Oh, I don't want you to. Do not put that anywhere near me. Put that on your hands.
Come on, baby.
Rub it on
Come on, let's do a little butt stuff.
Dave liked it. I rubbed it on his back live for the world to see, and he's still got a bump.
We got.
I like that there's no footage of that saved anywhere.
Somewhere. I have it. We also have Davis's brother in studio tonight. He's looking very uncomfortable. He's like, wow, this is what my brother talks about on a podcast.
I figured, you know, I'd show him what I do for a living.
About fucking other dudes.
Well, what I really wanted to him to see is just how sad and pathetic I really am. So enjoy, little bro. It's gonna be a long ride home. I'll probably cry.
Yeah, but who's going to acting school and who isn't? Well, so you win.
He's also in high school.
You could have left that part out.
Ladies, he's in high school.
Hit him up. Hey Evan, what's your Twitter?
Or Snapchat.
Shout out. Yeah, what's your Snapchat?
Is that underscore eClark12?
No, eClark10, right? Tell the world.
Tell the world.
All Instagram.
Look it up.
Come on.
I gotta look at it real quick.
Trust me, no one listens to this show. You're gonna be fine. Just on
Instagram. He gets 400 followers in the next
Evan
8 hours.
Evan.Clark10.
Hit him up.
High school selfie. Because he's a 10 out of 10, ladies. You heard it here first on The Plunge. First on Adam and Eve, now on the airways. Evan Clark. E.Clark10. What was his thing?
Evan.Clark10.
Evan.Clark10.
Close enough.
Look up E.Clark10 and throw them a follow too.
All right, so let's get right into our topics. I have developed a gambling addiction, and it's not good.
Yeah? On your vacation?
Yeah.
You want to talk about it?
No.
I have a spending issue.
Okay.
Like, I just don't have money. Like,
Tuba, you're banned for the next year.
Sorry about that.
Tuba is getting growingly upset that he's not allowed on the show.
Yeah, we've noticed.
Yeah.
I've noticed.
The thing is, I think we need to keep the band because the amount of people who've hit me up and been like, hey, Tuba's a gimmick, right? It's not a real person. Despite him being on like 4 episodes.
Yeah, he's not sounding like any of us.
Yeah. Yeah, they're like,
hey guys.
Yeah, they're like, the Tuba thing's a gimmick, right?
What
like
about the NBA?
People don't think Tuba's real. And I think that's the funniest thing ever.
I can't believe we need to
keep up with the band.
You know what's great is that people believe that Stewie's a real person more than they believe Tuba's a real person.
And they've never heard Stewie.
Never heard Stewie speak. Never seen his face.
They heard his...
His robotic voice on Discord.
His Discord voice, yeah.
But Stewie has never been seen, heard, anywhere. Oh, actually, that's not true. I
on the Instagram.
They're redacted, yeah.
No, we on the Instagram, I posted a picture of me and him for
take
his
it
birthday.
Down now.
I'm going to have to... Oh, you're probably right. It's been out there for... It's like the second post.
Yeah, it's the first post we ever made.
Yeah, so
I'm
going to
delete that right
you
now.
You OG listeners know what producer Stu looks like.
The rest,
fuck
the rest of
you.
Of you fakers, you'll never... Unless you go on Instagram right now.
Yeah.
Oh, if back in time.
Back in time.
So I told myself I was probably going to get into gambling after I started having an income anyway. But then I spent, like, probably 24 hours cumulatively in a casino.
Wow. Out of how much time on your cruise?
Six days? Like, one sixth of the time was spent in a casino, probably. So, you
what's
know.
What's 24 times six? Math dude.
144? No, 148.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm not going to fact check that or anything. We got Davis on the sticks.
I am getting wine drunk for fun.
I went on a podcast.
I'm getting beer drunk.
I'm drinking Natty Rush.
The voice from beyond is just getting drunk.
Yeah, Tim, you showed up today and you were like, hey, man, they don't have Four Loko in this state. So I got a bunch of Natty Rushes.
144 is the
correct
answer. At
least in the gas station I went to. So I said, you know what? Natty Rush will do because it's the same thing. Honestly, I think it tastes better, but that's just me.
That 8% watermelon Natty Ice is going down smooth.
No, the official flavor is blue frostbite.
That sounds like a shitty alcoholic Gatorade.
It tastes like it too.
How much percent is that?
8%, dude.
8%?
Yeah, and that's a tall boy too. So like,
and yeah, 25 fluid ounces. So it's
so
like
the only reason you're drinking it is because it's alcoholic. Like it's severely alcoholic. You're not enjoying that whatsoever.
$2.19. My pocket loves it.
So Tim, welcome to the show. You're a college boy. You're our frat boy friend. So I thought it was we get called the frat boy podcast often because we're
really?
Younger than most of our friends. They say it brings them back, but they're also like, I hate you guys. But you're the true epitome of frat boy.
Yeah. Tim is OG frat star.
Yeah.
Like, the first frat star in history. No
so you're the president of your frat.
You're the president of your frat?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah. So
Do you beat freshmen?
No, so last year he was the
illegal.
Spank master. That was his title.
Spank master Timmy.
Yeah,
that's
spank
illegal.
Master.
It's
illegal?
That can't be.
Yeah,
you can't
legally
confirm.
He can't be said. He can't be said saying he spanks people.
So you
I
can't,
don't
you,
spank
so
people.
You can't confirm that.
Let the lawyers listening to this, I don't spank people. That's hazing.
Me.
That's illegal.
Yeah, guys. Wink, wink. He doesn't spank people. Oh.
Arizona State follows all the rules.
Yeah.
Wink, wink.
Joke's on you. I'm not people.
So shout out DJ Century. He's always rocking ASU stuff. The homie casual is always wearing U of A. So you have any comments for the homie casual and his University of Arizona?
The fuck, University of Arizona? Didn't we just smacked them around in basketball today. Rivalry weekend, so I guess suck my dick. I don't know what else I'm going to tell you.
So flat.
It is what it is. That's about it.
Now, Tim, the first thing I ever received from you at college.
Oh,
You go ghost often. But we hear from you, like, once every, like, 3 months. The first thing I ever got, it was, like, 6 a.m. my time. I had woken up early for some reason, and I had just gotten a text from you. And it was just a selfie of you with, like, another dude, and you were just throwing up peace signs next to, like, a naked woman who you had just sexed.
Some gang shit right there.
That's
my girlfriend's gonna listen to this.
And?
Have you not told her the story yet? Because you probably should have.
Probably should
have. You probably should have told the story a long
time
ago.
It is your profile. It is your contact photo for me. So like, I think
it
needs to
really?
Come up. Yeah.
That's surprising.
It's all I know about you in terms of college too. So that's how I see you for everything now.
I mean, the first time Tim talked to me, he didn't talk to me all of first semester. And then he was in Florida all that December. And then the February of second semester, all he sent me was a short GIF from, like, the history of the world, or of everything, I guess. And it just said, hey, thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage. And then I said, hey, Tim, how's you ASU? And he just didn't answer until summer.
Like I said, that's a very personal question to ask. And I don't think me and fucking Under Armour boy over here are on that level.
It's not, hey, no free ads.
Yeah.
Fuck you, Under Armour. Unless you want to sponsor us, hit us up at the Plunge Outlook.
That's not anything close to what our email is.
Why
but
do
I
you
appreciate
talk?
Your try.
Why do you
it's plungepodcast@outlook.com.
Don't tell the public that. Wait, no. Do tell the public that. Send us emails. We're a business.
We're a business.
Jesus.
Does that make me a businessman?
No.
No.
I'm a businessman. Jay-Z?
No, no
one.
No.
I'm
no
a one. Businessman.
I don't know that one.
Didn't he cheat on Beyonce and then she fucked on him?
No, she made Lemonade. A whole album, made a whole lot of money, and then they made another album.
Is it Lemonade or Lemon Party?
It's Lemonade, yeah.
Okay.
She made Lemonade, about him cheating. Lemonhead. Made a whole buttload of money.
Lemons!
And then they made the next album, The Carters, is that what it's called?
The
artist is
and
the
And then Cardi B became
You're thinking
famous
of Carter's
world
Lil Wayne.
Yes.
That's not correct at all.
No? The Carter 5, baby.
The Carter,
is it not?
The Carter, five. Yeah, but no, their rap duo name is The Carters. You never heard Ape Shit?
Is that the whole song?
Yeah, pretty much. They're in the Louvre.
What, I want to shake that thing.
That's Sean Paul.
That's Sean Paul.
Yeah, that is Sean Paul.
Oh, Jesus fuck. All right, Captain Marvel. We have a new charity bin rule just today only.
Okay.
Is if you spoil Captain Marvel, it's $5. Any spoiler, $5 to the charity bin. So I saw that with many of the people in the room. Shout out newly acquired A-Team Davey. He's sitting at the desk right now.
Davey, wavy, splashy, wavy.
Shout out.
Splashy,
do not
gravy.
Fucking talk because you're a producer.
Yeah.
Yeah, you cockbite.
Yeah. I went with Tim. I went with Davis.
Yep.
We went with B-Team Bin.
Yep. Unfortunately, I was plus, not there because I
oh,
was
and C-Team Will.
C-Team. C-plus Team Will.
C-plus Team Will. So we saw that today.
Which am I?
Good movie.
It was actually very good. I was surprised how good it was.
So me and Davis have had an ongoing battle for the past.
Yes.
I don't know.
Pretty much since
the last Avengers came out.
Yep.
That he was adamant that Captain America was the best, and I was like, no, like Captain Marvel could wipe the floor with Captain America.
To be fair,
with ease.
To be fair, I will say this before this we go forward. Captain Marvel is one of those heroes that I've never heard about until like this movie came out. I had no idea who Captain Marvel was.
Uh-huh.
Like when they first released the name, I didn't even know it was a female. I had no idea who
Captain
Marvel was.
Dude.
So, I stuck to my guns for that long until I saw the movie. Until
you saw the movie, there was one scene.
There was one scene where I was like, okay. I fought it a couple times. I fought it for as long as I could throughout this movie.
There was one scene where she just went like she went super saiyan.
Yeah,
and I just looked over at Davis and I just smiled and he's like, "Fuck off,
yeah.
I know."
I have nothing more to say. Like, I'm sorry, Cap. I'm sorry, Steve Rogers. I love you to death, but she'd wipe the floor with your ass, man. She
yeah.
really would.
Well, that's the thing with her is she has that Superman role where she's so fucking powerful that, like, you can't make that good of a movie about her because, she, like, no one can really defeat her.
No one can defeat
her. So it's like, it's good they waited this long. They have a fucking Thanos waiting that,
yeah.
like, you get to be like, okay, that's an adamant, like,
but it was
opponent.
I saw it as less of a story about her as a superhero and more of just, like, it was a movie about, like, who she was.
Yeah.
And what it meant. Like, there was a point where it was kind of, like, what it meant to be a human.
Yeah.
If you want to get that deep, which I like to get that deep.
Also, shout out Kyle for saying he would get fucked by a big green, wait, purple guy.
On, like, episode 8? Yeah.
Yes. Shout out Kyle.
A big purple man.
But I was a fan
Josh
of the movie. I it's an unpopular opinion. I don't know how you guys feel about it, but the people I've talked to about it, it's an unpopular opinion. I love Brie Larson.
Oh yeah,
like, I think she's foxy.
Is she hot?
So like,
I think she's foxy.
The entire movie,
Larson.
I wanted to hate fuck her.
Oh yeah,
you know,
oh,
like,
it was right there. I
like,
was like, give me the like, use those powers against me. In
but
the
like, she was like the perfect amount of sassy
oh,
and
yeah.
like kind of a bitch, but also like it was cute though too. Where I was like, oh my god,
it's like I hate her. But
she would flirt with you, and it was more of like a like oh like. You can't touch this.
I would.
No
I would
way.
Let her choke me.
And you haven't even seen it.
I haven't even seen
you
it.
Might
even
jerk, you might have
like,
to jerk
I'm,
off in the theater.
Like, dude, I already
you
have.
Might have to jerk off in the theater, man.
I did when we watched Wreck-It Ralph 2, Ralph Wrecks the Internet, or
you
whatever
did?
The fuck it's called.
Friend.
Fucking worst
That's
movie
not
of all
even
time.
From the movie. That's from the Inbetweeners.
Excuse me?
That's from the Inbetweeners.
No, that's from the Wreck-It Ralph 2.
No, it absolutely
no, it is at the
is
end.
Not.
At the end where
oh,
yeah,
no, the
where they create
yeah,
all
right.
the Ralphs and they make one Mega Ralph and they're running after Vanellope going friend.
Sounds
terrible.
Spoiler alert for Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Yes, all right, you know, fuck you. I want to spoil Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Don't waste your money.
Don't
movie.
Don't go watch
horrible
it.
Movie.
No, that was a Cash Money movie. What the fuck are you talking about? I bet you didn't even see. You're a fake fan.
I'm not
a fan.
I'm a fan of Wreck-It Ralph.
I'm a fan of the first one.
Yeah, the second one. Don't watch the second.
Wreck-It Ralph's got a fucking wagon.
But yeah, pretty much, I want to hate fuck Brie Larson as Captain Marvel. It's unreal how she plays that role. Of just like,
she was really good. She was very good at it. And I have a lot of good things.
Like,
to
I'll say,
about that movie.
Gal Gadot set the bar really high for like the woman superhero.
Oh
right
yes,
now.
Absolutely.
And I'm not gonna say she beat it, but she definitely met it.
She held her own. She definitely held her own against.
I will say one thing: she looks so stupid when she runs in action scenes.
Oh my god! Or even just like casual jogging with, like when her and Fury were like casually jogging like away from like
does he have something?
They just looked stupid.
He's got two eyes.
Oh, he's got two eyes.
I will say, this isn't a spoiler. It's more of like you knew this going in that they would do this.
It's in the trailers, yeah.
They show you how he's gonna lose his eye.
Is it fucking his boss?
Yeah, it is.
We will let the
we'll let you find out. Also, we'll let you find out.
Also, this movie only heightened my hate for cats. That's all I'm gonna say. It heightened my hate for cats.
Shout out cats. Shout out Goose.
Shout out Goose the cat.
I got a question for you guys.
Yeah.
If you could trade anyone from, like, you had to, like, it's trade deadline. You gotta open up cap space, no pun intended. You gotta trade cap space from Marvel to DC.
Yeah.
Who would you trade?
Batman for. I have to make a trade, right?
Wait, do
I get someone in return?
Like DC is getting someone from Marvel, and someone from Marvel is getting.
Okay, so it's clearly. Wait, are we talking power or coolness?
It's up to you.
I'm gonna go coolness because like Batman's way cooler than Superman, but Superman can wipe the floor with literally everyone. And there's no kryptonite in Marvel. It's indestructible.
Yeah.
I would change now.
I would still bring Batman.
Yeah, you gotta bring Batman.
I would bring Aquaman.
Oh, fuck that.
Why?
You want Jason Elmy in your universe?
I'm bringing Christian Bale's Batman.
Yep.
We're bringing Ben Affleck's... John Hamm.
John Hamm's unexistent
John
Batman.
Hamm's Batman.
I'm in on that.
And
who would I get rid of?
Gamora.
I would get rid of Edward Norton's Hulk.
Yeah, that's a good trade.
Yeah,
good
Edward
deal.
No,
so it's got to be current.
Excluding that.
So current MCU.
Current MCU minus the original Incredible Hulk.
Gamora.
I'm going to trade Vision because he's a dead little bitch right now.
I'm going to send over... What's Wanda's brother's name?
The running guy?
Yeah, is it Quicksilver?
Forrest Gump.
I'm sending Quicksilver over.
So
cool. I would send over Forrest Gump. Marvel.
We just edited the Forrest Gump Wikipedia like 10 minutes ago. It said on the page now, if you go to the Forrest Gump wiki, during like the running scene, it just says, and Forrest killed time during his run by he killed time on his run by run.
Rum.
Sorry,
rum.
The wine's hitting me now.
Red wine is
Forrest
hitting me.
Killed time during his run by listening to the hip podcast, the Plunge podcast.
Do you have a comedy show
about running.
Do you have any grifts for us?
Fuck you.
Dude, you've drank and you haven't even...
I've drank an entire bottle of wine and we're just getting going.
Yeah, you ripped a few shots and a couple BL smoothies.
Yeah, I had a couple BL smoothies. That's a Bud Light for all you people out there.
Those who don't know what a BL smoothie is.
Yeah.
Bacon lettuce.
But, bacon lettuce smoothie.
Hold the tomato.
Hold the tomato.
You put it in a blender.
It's not lovely.
It tastes like hamburger grease for some reason.
For some reason.
Yummy.
No. Captain Marvel is very good. It filled a lot of the gaps of like questions.
Full circle now. It's full circle.
Yeah, it filled a lot of the gaps in the question of the MCU.
You guys want to go see it again?
Nope.
Kinda. I'll see
it. Not with you.
Fuck you. You leave tomorrow. Go back to Arizona.
Running away.
That's a buck.
Yeah, it is.
$11.
I'm not paying for you anymore.
You filmed a trap card.
It was really good. Go see it.
Go see it.
Go see it.
Sponsored by Marvel.
Yeah. Sponsored by Marvel.
I wish. I won.
Also loved where she gets the name. Like I said,
yeah.
That was my biggest question going in. Like,
actually,
where is she getting the name?
To be fair, she never really got a name. The movie should just be titled Carol.
It really should. Or what's her other?
Carol Danvers.
No. What's her Cree name?
Fear.
Varys. Called Varys.
Fears. Honestly, speaking of trades, what do you guys think of the AB situation? Where you think
he's coming to the Pats?
If he comes to the Pats, I'm getting a tattoo of
him
9-time Super Bowl champs on my butt.
Because we're winning another three if Antonio Brown comes.
That's a bold strategy, Kyle.
He's coming to the Pats. It's the only thing that makes sense. He's somehow become the only person in the world who has a contract for 3 years yet still has free agency power.
Yeah, anyone else notice he has a bleach blonde mustache?
It's great.
It's disgusting. Like, that's just the power that professional athletes have. They can look like idiots, and people look at them and go, that's style.
Yeah, it's style. AB is style.
Like, NBA players will walk in to their games wearing a construction outfit, and someone will pay thousands of dollars for it.
Yeah, if Russell Westbrook wears it, it's fucking high fashion.
It's such high fashion. AB bleached his mustache, and people are going, wow, he is a genius.
So, I thought it was funny. I went to bed the other night thinking he was a Buffalo Bill. I woke up, and he was no longer a Buffalo Bill.
Did they actually get him?
For like no, never. They did, never. And then he was, pretty much, he was like, yeah, no, fuck that. I'm not going to Buffalo. Wow. And they were like, okay, we'll trade you somewhere else.
Wow.
Basically, yeah.
So if he gets traded to the Pats, we're getting him from the Bills.
So what needs to happen, that's the trouble right now, is what needs to happen is there needs to be strong leadership already present to deal with him, because no teams will take him.
Nope.
So, like, none of the teams without strong leadership will take AB. AB is Antonio Brown, for all of you out there. Non-sports people. Shout out Mikey. Shout out Mikey, my brother. He said, I don't get your podcast when you talk about sports. So, Antonio Brown, star wide receiver.
Star wide receiver.
Star wide receiver. He pretty much was like, yeah, no, fuck the Bills. I'm not going there. So now he has his own pretty much say in where he goes. All right, so, like, where are the top three landing places for him, realistically?
I think the Niners have to be up there.
The Raiders have the draft picks and decent talent. The Pats aren't even in it, but that would be hilarious. And, obviously, well, like, the Packers.
Well, that's where all the people with all the fucking issues go, is they go to the Pats, and then they play four games and get suspended for smoking weed.
Or they become Randy Moss. Or just one guy. At Olympia Sports the other day, and there was just a Flash Gordon shirt with him looking thugged out, and it was on the clearance rack, and I was like, I need that.
I love how it's already on the clearance rack.
Yeah.
But no, like the Steelers. So is he coming? Is he technically on the
Bills?
You're
going to say he's going to be traded to the Steelers.
No, he's on the Bills.
No, he's on the Steelers. That trade fell through.
Okay, so technically, the Steelers won't trade him to New England. I was thinking if he's on the Bills, Buffalo might give him to us.
Technically, the Steelers, they have a 3-year contract. There's nothing he can do about that. Technically, the Steelers could just be like, yeah, play for us or retire. We have you for 3 years. Yeah, but, like, they want to get returning for him. So, yeah. Like, that won't happen. But they could, technically.
I'm excited.
The Steelers clearly would rather burn to the ground than send them to the Pats.
I was going to say, clearly the Steelers, like, they're willing to wait it out. They've proved that.
Yeah, they have.
Le'Veon.
Yeah. Yeah. I need them to go together to Indy, and then just
that would be fucking
just Andrew
sick.
Luck hitting his prime with Antonio Brown, T.Y. Hilton, and Le'Veon Bell.
That would be scary.
Marlon Mack transfers to a slot receiver.
That would be terrifying.
Marlon Mack did not do enough for me this season. He had a few good weeks, but
Davis, do you want to ask who was on our fantasy team?
Wait, we did have a fantasy team.
So Riley, what are your thoughts on Michael Jackson?
Riley brought up a great point. We had a fantasy
team. like Neverland.
I want to feel you, little kid. I'm a little boy forever.
We had a fantasy
team. Hey! I want your loving, PYT, little kid. I want to sleep with you, little boy.
he's just a cool dude.
I'll make an amusement park, little boy, for your pleasure. I want to sleep with you, little boy.
We had a fantasy team, right?
Yes.
Was Michael Jackson on it?
Yes. He was our starting running back.
Why did no one tell me that?
He was a real sleeper.
He runs an NFL.
Yeah, that was right. Yeah.
Get in there. Who's our quarterback?
David Bowie.
Funny. Running back. He runs back the years on the little boys he touched.
I want to diddle you, little boy. You little boy. I'll stick my finger, little boy, in your asshole. And I want that little boy poon in my D.
Hey, Riley.
Hey.
I'm going to buy you
a drink. And then.
But actually, what are your thoughts on him?
He's fucked up. It's fucked up. Michael Jackson's a sick fuck. Everyone knew it, but now there's proof because of HBO. I don't know.
There's actual proof?
Yeah, there's. You know how we made our TLC pitch of Children of Netherland Ranch?
Did we secretly pitch a show to HBO?
Yeah, no. Literally, like the week after we made our TLC pitch of The Children of Neverland Ranch, HBO dropped Leaving Neverland, which was literally just a docuseries of Michael Jackson and how he's guilty and his kid diddling and how a bunch of kids, like, he used to just sleep over with little boys and shit.
That's really fucking creepy.
Which, like, the world is going nuts over this.
The world's going nuts in general.
This isn't new news.
No, it's not new news.
Like, I'm only 22. Michael Jackson died when 22. I was, like... 22! Michael Jackson died when I was maybe, like, 13.
We were 12.
This was known. Yeah. This was known that Michael Jackson diddled kids. I don't know why there's an outrage now. Like, it's shitty. He's a fucked up person. But, like, this isn't new news.
No, it's
like,
not.
Do you think he gave him, like, annual passes after he got finished with them?
Hey,
like,
little
a
flash boy.
Pass? Like,
do you
want to
come back to the
ride?
Do you want to come back to the
Neverland
Ranch?
Put a flash pass to the ride.
Ruining Disneyland.
Flash passes.
You want a flash pass to the
hey,
ride?
Hey, little boy.
The single
if you come
flag?
Sleep in my bed, I'll let you play in my amusement park.
Like, South Park has, like, 10 episodes about it.
Like, this isn't new news. Like, people have known Michael Jackson diddles kids. I don't know why it's, like, now there's proof or more proof than before. It's like, yeah, no, everybody knew this. He used to throw children off of balconies and fuck little kids for fun. Prince. Everyone knew this. I don't know. There's outrage now. It's like, Billie Jean is still a bop. I'm going to listen to it. And just beat it!
Beat it!
Beat it! Beat it! No one wants to beat it. If there is a little kid in my bed, I'm gonna beat him over the head. Then fuck him. Just
with roofies.
Like, it's old news.
Yeah, that's not even offensive, because that's straight up true.
Facts. If it's not
good
offensive, it's facts.
Good song, guys.
Great song. Well done, Bo. Spot on.
Hey, cheers, Riley.
So as many of you do know, us on the Plunge podcast have an up and down relationship with PETA.
Yeah, beefing with PETA.
Beefing with PETA.
That's funny.
Beefing with PETA.
We have more beef with PETA, though. So last week was the...
I bet they hate that, because, you know...
Yeah, because beef. So last week, it was the anniversary of Steve Irwin's death.
And Hunter, Absolute legend.
So, Hunter, I don't know if you care about this. I went swimming with stingrays last week on my vacation.
You could have died.
About it?
You could have died.
I couldn't have, because it was a freak accident.
You should have punched one.
Not, it's not a freak accident when it happens to Steve Irwin.
Okay? He got stung in the heart. That's just how it happens. Literally, do you want to know how many people, like, we went on a snorkeling trip. Every single person was like, wait, there's stingrays in here? What about Steve Irwin? I heard Steve Irwin probably 14 times. Like,
dude, there's nothing wrong with swimming with a good stingray. You just got to debarb them. And
they were barbed. They were wild. And, like, honestly, I was over them, and I was terrified.
I gotta say, we're coming into a new era. I'm not gonna be salty about your vacations. I have learned.
Well,
from
you know, the thing is,
I'm
done with vacations now, so I'm glad you're okay with them now.
Yeah, I'm fine with it now that you're not going on anymore. And shout out Homie Casual for teaching me my wrongdoings. Go listen to him and DJ Sentry over at the Hood Diner podcast.
So I was snorkeling and there was like a 30 foot, real big. It was like a 15 foot stingray.
Like 30 feet.
And it had like a 25 foot stinger.
15 feet?
Yeah.
A manta
it was
ray.
Huge.
Stingray.
And it was like, it was just burrowed in the sand, like
Were
chilling.
Were you drunk?
No.
Definitely.
I don't believe you.
I was drunk most of this trip. But I was not drunk then. You don't drunk snorkel because then you slap a turtle in the face and you eat your dick off.
Has that happened before?
I don't know.
Do stingrays even have mouths?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I was over this stingray and it had like a 25 foot stinger. And I was just like, in my mind, I was like, Steve Irwin had one of those.
In his heart.
And then I was like, wait, this guy's not fucking moving. He was just dormant, like, taking a nap. So I was like, okay, I'm fine.
Did you slap him on the cheeks and then clap those cheeks?
No, because it was, like, 30 feet down. So I would have had to go slap the shit out of him.
No, that's one of the top 10 anime betrayals from Top 10 Mojo.
Top 10 Mojo Show.
Sponsored, by the way.
So, PETA. So last week, Google, as you know, Google does their, when they have the Google, like, art, sometimes they do a special one if there's a theme day. They made one that was Steve Irwin themed. And it had him, like, it had G-O, and then his face was the other O. He's holding a crocodile. The crocodile was, like, biting the L. So PETA quote tweets that and says, Steve Irwin was killed while harassing a ray. He dangled his baby while feeding a crocodile and wrestled wild animals who were minding their own business. Today's Google Doodle sends a dangerous fawning message. Wild animals are entitled to be left alone in their natural habitats.
Boo!
They sent a bunch more tweets. They said Steve Irwin's actions were not on target with his supposed message of protecting wildlife. A real wildlife expert and someone who respects animals leaves them for their own business and their own natural habitat. It is harassment, to drag exotic animals, including babies taken from their mothers, around from TV talk shows to conferences and force them to perform as Steve Irwin did. Animals deserve to live as they want to, not as humans demand.
He literally would just like...
Fuck you, PETA!
I hate PETA.
You
would
literally just like fucking poke them and they'd be like, ugh! Well, oh, what's up, bro?
Fuck you, what? PETA. That's my stand. Dude, the Plunge hates PETA.
I know, he loved them.
That's what I'm saying. Like, he appreciated them
enough. He used animals to educate us about animals. He wanted not only...
Why do you know about animals?
Because of Steve Irwin.
Why do you know about animals?
Because of Steve Irwin.
Why do you know about animals?
Because of the crocodile hunter.
The crocodile hunter.
I watched that man to learn about animals. He taught me shit. He resonated with the hearts of the world. And this motherfucking company is going to try to say he harasses animals. You can suck a dick, PETA.
Suck
a
dick.
I hate you.
I hate you,
PETA. You piece of shit. We're back on bad terms, PETA. I think we were already on bad terms.
You don't exist.
Fuck you, PETA.
You don't exist.
Shout out all the offensive tweets that had hashtag donate from PETA, and they supported those. Yeah, fuck you, PETA.
I'm going to stick my kosher-ass dick down your PETA throat. Fuck you, PETA.
Yeah.
You're not Jewish. Just going to throw that out there.
I'm moving on from PETA. They're a piece of shit, okay?
Yeah. Well, I think we're just going to ignore that.
Okay.
Fuck PETA.
Yeah, actually, fuck PETA.
Have you guys seen the cheese challenge?
Oh my god!
I've seen the what's his name? The Colton challenge.
What's the Colton challenge?
The Colton challenge is people trying to jump over fences that are a little too big.
Oh, from The Bachelor, right?
The Bachelor, yeah.
Yeah. So the last episode of The Bachelor, it was the finale, right? And this dude just jumped a fence.
What happened?
I don't watch The Bachelor. I don't have a girlfriend. We're all single. I don't know. Keep informing us.
Guilty pleasure. I watch The Bachelor because it's entertaining as fuck. So it was one of the last episodes, and the girl he was going to pick, like the final girl he was going to pick to propose to, said she wasn't ready for marriage, and it broke his heart, and she left.
Isn't the point to get married?
Well, see, some of them go on there to exclusively get known and eventually get on their
own. To become the next Bachelor.
To the next Bachelorette.
The Bachelorette, yeah.
Like brown sugar.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm just making up words that sound like they could be a Bachelor.
So
that's right.
She left.
Ikra, I go to school with her. I call her my little brown sugar. We're not exclusive and we're not dating or in a sexual date of any kind. No, I'm not. Love you, brown sugar.
All right. So she leaves and Colton's just like torn apart. He went through all these different girls, had to break all these different girls' hearts, and the one he picked doesn't want him right now. He jumped the fence, left the set. Chris Hansen had to chase him down himself. The cameras couldn't find him, and the episode just ended. We have no idea where this man is. It was fucking wild. So people on Instagram are doing the Colton challenge where they try to hop a fence that's about, 6 to 7 feet
tall. Yeah.
Because that's
Is he just an athletic freak? Like,
he's a former NFL football player.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, not successfully, playing practice squad at best.
Yeah.
He's
fit as fuck.
He's a fit boy. He's a good
guy. I just saw him.
I'd marry him.
I saw a clip of him just saying the word, nailed it, like 18 times. Is that a thing he does?
Could be. Yeah.
Wait, so what's the cheese challenge?
What is a cheese challenge?
The cheese challenge is people lately have been taking videos of them. So fuck all the people who still use like Kraft single cheese. You are losers. Mm. Go to the fucking deli. Get some real cheese, you motherfuckers.
Yeah. Shout out Robert Kraft.
Kraft. Fuck you, cheese. Sam PC. Fucking Robert Kraft is not the owner of Kraft Cheese or Mac and Cheese.
Yeah,
he is a paper company because he's fucking Dunder Mifflin.
Dunder Mifflin?
Yes.
He owns Dunder Mifflin.
Yes. So fuck you. Robert Kraft is not the Mac and Cheese. Oh, no. Suck a dick, Adam. So the cheese challenge is people have just been taking a single slice of cheese from like a Kraft Singles and they take it and they just whip it at their dog. Their kitty.
Is that with the fucking cat with
their
the cheese?
Yeah,
on
their
faces?
Kitten, their babies, their boyfriends, girlfriends, friends.
It's quite degrading, honestly.
Yeah, so they're just taking cheese and they're whipping it at various alive beings and taking a video of their reaction. Mostly cats and babies have been the one that have been popular most because they can't, like, if someone throws a piece of cheese at my face, I'm going to take it off. But a baby's just going to be like,
baby's
I'm
going to
eat that shit like Kobe.
Producer Dave, you got one ready? Throw it up on there.
What the fuck is the. What if the baby's lactose intolerant?
I don't think
oh no!
I don't think they have cheese.
All right, so we got a little baby crawling around, and cheese on the forehead.
And she's loving
it. And she's smiling. She's like, yeah, there's cheese on my head.
She doesn't know what cheese is yet, but she's on my head.
Honestly, I don't even know what cheese is.
All right, we got another little bit. Just cheese. Oh, no.
Oh, it's in his hair.
She wants to kill someone.
She looks like she just shit herself.
Oh, God.
She's upset.
All right, so yeah, the cheese.
Oh, that one was.
What do you guys think of this?
I think it's kind of just one of those things where it's like, is this necessary?
I hope the people that are doing this fucking die. This is the dumbest shit.
Like, ever. It's not very funny. Like, it's entertaining. It's not very funny.
That's child abuse. You're throwing cheese at a child.
Not child abuse. It's just one of those things where it's like, I'm not getting anything out of it. Really, I'm not really getting much out of this. You know, I'm just gonna
I mean, I get a lot, but that's for a different time.
I've made a decision, executively, because I run this show.
Yeah,
me too. What is? Hey. What is the decision?
We're doing a plunge picks in about 10 minutes. The loser of this of the plunge picks will do a 1-day challenge. Has to get cheesed.
Can I volunteer for that? Honestly,
just pick a bad team on purpose.
No. We'll see. You can do it in addition to whoever loses if you don't lose.
Talk about pepper jack cheese. I love pepper jack cheese.
Yeah. We're gonna get pepper jack so you it hurts your eyes.
Can we get shredded so we just sprinkle it on our head?
Yeah, we're gonna pour some fucking like parmesan. It's gonna look like dandruff.
Can we squirt with string cheese? Like cheese?
Yeah.
Shout out to the episode where I drank a thing of queso.
Queso. It was so disgusting to listen to.
Queefo.
So disgusting to listen to.
Oh, God. All right, so we'll get to our plunge picks. We got a couple things to cover first.
I picked Plymouth State University alumni Riley Trudell.
For what?
We didn't even discuss.
For your animated movies?
Is that the topic?
Yeah.
Animated movies.
Best animated movie. Riley at Plymouth State University.
Elf. Trudell.
All right, next up, we got R. Kelly. Did you guys see the video of him being like, I'm just trying to live, man?
I have not, but I'm excited to watch it right now.
His lawyer came out and he's like, yeah, this man's guilty as shit. Dave, can you play the video of him saying, I'm fighting for my life, man?
This is great, because R. Kelly's just been...
Kelly pissing on little children, fucking 14-year-olds.
That documentary was wild.
Not it at all.
Is he the black Michael Jackson?
You need, like, an 8-second clip.
Michael Jackson was the black Michael Jackson.
Oh, you're right.
He turned white. I'm fighting for my fucking life,
fighting for my fucking life, man! All right, Dave has the clip of R. Kelly right now.
Play that shit.
I'm fighting for my fucking life, man.
I didn't do this stuff. This is not me. I'm fighting for my life. Y'all killing me with this. I gave y'all 30 years of my career.
Robert.
30 years of my career. Y'all trying to kill me. You killing me, man. This is not about music. I'm trying to have a relationship with my kids, and I can't do it. Y'all just don't want to believe the truth. You don't want to believe it.
Brad, so R. Kelly's
fogging up.
I'm so excited.
He's not even R. Kelly.
I'm so
excited. R. Kelly is so fucked. That piece of shit is going to jail. He's made some bops, but goddamn. This week is the week of R&B bop makers going to fuck. Well, MJ's dead.
No, Tekashi 6ix9ine is in, I almost said rehab.
Tekashi 6ix9ine's a little snitch who's going to be out of prison soon.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, but he's going into WITSEC.
He's not even real anymore.
Gone. No, like R. Kelly's fucked. It's so great. I wish Michael Jackson was alive so we could rot in prison like R. Kelly.
He is in spirit.
Yeah, right.
I'm a little boy forever.
Well, he's in hell. He touched. Wait, no, that's not in the Bible. Never mind.
Do you? Is it not in the Bible that if you touch little boys, you go to hell?
I'm pretty sure it's in the Bible.
Don't priests touch little boys?
Yeah, and there you go.
Shout out priests.
Shout out priests.
Fast track to the Bible. To the hell.
The fast the track hell. To the Bible.
They know their Bible, real well.
I have nothing. No, never mind. We're not on that. We're not on that topic yet. We're at Trump.
That ain't no problem. That ain't no problem. Yeah, no.
Shane does not touch.
I don't know. R. Kelly, is he going to prison? Like, Dave, do you know about this? Is he? He's going what? For how many years?
He got bailed.
He got bailed?
Yeah.
Like, he's on bail, but he's going back. He's going to prison, right?
They're still deciding.
We gotta bleep all of. He's still facing trial. We gotta bleep all.
No. He ain't two bars, dude. We're good.
Oh, facts. Yeah. Say hi, Davey. Wavy splash of gravy.
Fuck you, Hunter.
Yeah, bitch.
So, like, I said say hi.
I think
you heard me right.
I think R. Kelly's at the point where he's like, man, people are gonna start realizing I believe I can fly as about a 12-year-old. I need to change that.
Hey, still a huge fan of Ignition, though.
Great song.
It's a great song.
It's like bop. It's not a lie.
Is that R. Kelly?
Yeah.
Okay. Remix to Ignition.
Remix to Ignition.
Hot and spicy McChicken. Remix to the Ignition. Mama said we ain't stopping because we got food in the kitchen.
Sipping on
Little Women's pussy.
We don't have to say that.
Okay. Whatever the fuck you were saying, go back to that because that was better.
Trump has been Trump photos have been seen. Leaked of him with photos of the spa owner who owned the thing from Robert Kraft.
Really?
Which is a great look for Trump.
You think he just met up to get
There's
a high
no
five?
Way Trump hasn't gotten a rub and tug at that fucking spa.
Oh,
there
oh,
is
easily.
Absolutely no fucking
easily,
way.
Easily, dude.
That's the most Asian name I've ever seen, Lee Yang. That's not even racist. That's just straight up like Asian culture name.
It's the woman Yao Ming.
It's
you know?
The John Doe of Asia.
Lee Yang.
This is the LeBron James of like rub and tug places.
Wait, is he? Oh my god, this motherfucker. There's no way this man hasn't gotten rub and tugged.
Oh, dude, he's getting rub and tugged right the fuck now.
As we're talking. She probably does it with all the like the billionaires.
She's
Kraft,
got all
Warren Buffet.
Warren you can't Buffett. Put you can't put Trump and Kraft in the same category. This man's the president of the United States.
No, he's not.
If we're
he's
talking
a
about
fucking
in wealth,
movie star.
He's not a movie star. He's never he's been a movie star. Except Home Alone 2. Like
he's in like 10 seconds.
Yeah,
maybe like
yeah, and that's
seconds.
The best. That's better than any Stan Lee cameo.
Ooh.
Whoa.
That is a bold take. That's a bold take.
That's not a popular take around here, these parts.
We'll make a poll of that. Is Trump's cameo in Home Alone 2 better than any Stan Lee cameo?
Better than the
Guardians. Vote on
the
Twitter
Galaxy
at Plunge Podcast.
I will bet all of my college tuition.
Not better than his
Stan Lee.
Not better than his Big Hero 6 one, which a lot of people don't know about.
Trump's?
No, Stan Lee's Big Hero 6 cameo.
Wait, he had a Big Hero 6 cameo?
He's the father at the end.
That's Dad? Big Ooh. Dumb. That's real big dumb.
That's Stan Lee.
Nice.
Yeah. Wait, and what?
Big Hero 6.
That's stupid.
The Disney. End. He's the father.
All right. Damn. We'll jump into our last topic of the night before we get into some segments. The Jonas Brothers are back.
Oh, I love
this.
I have nothing to say.
I I'm never
so
saw Camp Rock.
You never what? Saw Camp Rock?
I never what? Saw it.
We rock. We rock. We rock.
Jonas Brothers are back. They'll be back for like 4 months.
Boys are back in town.
Listen,
boys
that's it.
Back
Listen,
town.
I was a big High School Musical guy.
Yep.
It's a big One Direction guy.
Yeah.
Even bigger No Direction guy.
Yeah. But the hashtag No Direction.
I have nothing to say about the Jonas Brothers.
I kind of like that they're back.
I got no opinion.
One of them's got big nipples.
So, like, the thing
it's
that I like...
making the girls horny again, which I guess is good for
The thing that facts. I like most is, like, they've each gone on their own ways. Like, Nick is a fucking, like, platinum-selling solo artist.
Married man.
Joe is a platinum-selling... He's in a group. What the fuck?
The song Cake by the Ocean?
Backstreet Boys.
Yes, Cake by the Ocean. What's the... saying that. Who's the artist of Cake by the Ocean? That's Joe Jonas. Is
Joe Jonas has big nipples.
People
I'm
hoping
be Kevin.
Cake by the and then Kevin's just returning to he's got to pay the bills.
Yeah, he's not you know well, he's not surviving off the
huge.
Old money anymore. So he's like, hey guys, we got to drop another album. So like,
yeah, Nick Jonas stopped being cute and now he's just hot as fuck. but he's
douche.
Got big nipples.
What a douche.
Shout out Dave, who's got dime nipples.
Dave has got the smallest nipples I've ever seen.
It's terrifying.
What was Joe Jonas's band? It was
Big Stupid. Big Stupid, the band on FM.
Dance, D-N-C-E, that's what it was.
D-N-C-E.
Why don't you just put the A in there? Like, God.
Are you that
stylistic choice.
Like,
it's a stylistic
choice. Like, I love Juice WRLD,
But just
no,
put the
you
O
mean
in.
Post Malone.
Juice WRLD. Juice WRLD slash Post Malone just put out a new album.
He did. I'm a fan.
Which one?
It's 22 songs.
I've only listened to like half of it.
That's a lot.
It's a lot.
Of songs. I'm gonna be honest. Shout out, listener Scott. He sent the one song that I hate the most to me this morning. He was like, "The song's fire." It's the one song where Juice WRLD tries singing.
Yes, I know.
It's called Robbery.
Yes. I love Robbery.
Dude, he's singing. He's not a good singer.
I love Robbery.
He's not a good singer.
Robbery's the best song on that album.
He's not a good singer. Like he said, let's play a little bit of it. Let's play a little. I'll get it.
Just play Cake by the Ocean.
Cake by the. Your 3000.
Cake. By the ocean.
We'll see who gets it first.
Year 3000 by the Jonas Brothers.
Year 3000.
I didn't download it, so I can't get it. I think it's garbage, so I can't listen. Like, this man tries singing in this song, and he's a rapper who's a really bad singer. So I couldn't get behind it.
This is the song Riley doesn't like.
It's called
like.
Robbery by Jonas Brothers' new album. Bring it up. Bring it forward. Skip to the middle a little bit.
Okay.
We got clout. Like, he's a bad singer.
I don't think that's the point, though. I just like the song.
I don't care if that's the point. He's a bad singer. He shouldn't sing. He should rap.
Doesn't exist.
I'm over it. I'm over it.
Doesn't exist.
In the back. Yeah, like, it's bad, dude. He can't sing. He should stick to rapping. Shout out Post Malone.
It's a sad boy song.
Shout out Post Malone.
I like the song.
Fast is a good song off that album. Go check it out if you want to hear some of that album. Juice WRLD, shout out Post Malone.
Juice WRLD slash Post Malone.
Yeah, Juice WRLD slash Post Malone, as confirmed by Cole. Shout out guest, episode 21.
Great guest. Great guest.
What were we fucking talking about? Jonas Brothers. Jonas
Brothers. The Joe Bros.
The Joe Bros are back. I haven't listened to their new song, but I hear it's a bop.
It's a new album.
Don't ever say bop and Jonas Brothers in the same sentence ever again.
She said, "I've been from the year 3000. Not much has changed, but they lived underwater.
I just have nothing
to say.
Great-great-great-granddaughter.
I love that song.
Doing fine. Doing fine. One day. I'm done.
Are you? I'm dumb.
All
right. I'm dumb.
I love the Joe Bros because when I was younger, probably like 18, 19, I was a...
So like last year?
Yeah, like literally like a year and a half ago. Just turned 21.
2.5 years ago, 3 years ago.
Back in my day.
I was a youngin' and I was like, you know what I'm going to do? My wedding, I'm going to get the Joe Bros to reunite and then
play at
my wedding. Yeah. I'm going to have that much clout and power. I'm going to bring the Joe Bros back. But they're already back, so that makes my life that much easier.
Well, so you know what we need to do? We need to break up the Joe Bros so you can bring them back at your wedding and prove to your wife that you got clout.
You know, they gave me a great idea for my wedding. If I have a wedding, I'm getting One Direction back together.
No Direction.
I'll get No Direction.
Can we have?
I'll get No Direction to open up for One Direction.
I assume all of No Direction will be at your wedding.
They'll be.
We need to perform.
We need to perform.
Shout out No Direction, me and Davis's boy band from high school.
Can I sub in for Davis and we can be some Direction?
The greatest moment of my life.
All right, we're going to hop into
Plunge Picks.
Yeah, we're going to hop into our segment. We're doing a Plunge Picks here today of best animated films of all time.
Best.
Backdoor Sluts 9, animated.
No, that comes with your Adam and Eve order.
Oh, wait.
Nice. All right, we got Plunge Picks coming up right now. We got special guest Evan in the house, Davis's little brother.
The man,
Evan Clark. You can follow him at evan.clark10 on Instagram.
I'm surprised you remembered.
Is our charity Bin going to you for the Special Olympics? Jesus.
All right, Davey, wavy splash. Right,
so we got producer
order.
So we got five of us in house. We got the order. We got
special.
Yeah, producer Dave, pick the order right now. So we got. Oh, he's gonna write it for us. All right, we got Evan first.
So
we're doing
pick.
Plunge Picks animated movies. All right?
We got Evan.
It's a Mount Rushmore, pretty much.
Hunter.
All right? You pick your top four, but we're going snake draft.
Davis.
Okay?
Yeah, gotcha.
Dave was... Fuck boy...
Fuck. So
R9 Lee.
So I'm last. Riley. All right. So our order is going.
Riley
Evan
always goes last.
Evan, Tim, Hunter, Davis, and according to Dave, Fuckboy Eiley.
For two. Riley gets two. Then it goes back, and Evan gets two.
Got it.
Riley
Evan?
Gets the very coveted and rarely seen 4-point play.
I know.
4-point play.
All right. So four. We're getting in there. It's top animated movies.
Is,
Evan, you have the
big.
First pick. This is an easy
this is
one.
Big. This is easy.
But you're like 16, so you probably won't pick it.
Yeah, easy. You probably.
All right. Well, my first
come
pick,
in closer.
My first pick, I got to go with one of the most popular, one of the most original. I got to go with Toy Story.
Okay,
oh,
that's
I
a good
get
pick.
Get that.
That's a good pick. Pick. That's a good pick. Okay.
That's not the number one.
It wasn't.
Just
it's not the
say.
Number one.
Number
there's
one.
A clear cut number one, and you didn't pick it, but it's fine.
That's a hell of a pick.
All right, Tim.
All right, I'm going to scoop up the slack and say The Lion King.
Yeah, all right, that's
clear
number one.
Clear number one.
But Toy Story 1, are you picking Toy Story 1?
Yeah.
Okay, great pick.
That was going to be number three.
Lion King is the definite pick here, but Tim, so good cop there.
I'm happy to be here.
Hey, producer, yeah, it's me.
Hunter's next, not me.
Da equal Hunter. Fuck you, Hunter.
All right, so Hunter, you're up.
I'm going to have to go with Shrek.
Shrek 1? Which
Shrek,
one?
Shrek 1.
Shrek 1, 2, 3, 4, or like any
Forever
of or Puss in Boots?
No.
Do you want Puss in Boots?
I'm going to go with Shrek 1.
Okay.
It's not bad.
It's
not bad.
Davis, you're up next.
I am up next. I'm going to go. I don't know if I want to use this. Yeah, you know, I'm going to go. I'm gonna go with the Iron Giant.
Fuck, that was my
I'm
pick.
Gonna go with the Iron Giant.
That's
no one was
that's
thinking about
pick.
It. I'm going with it, the Iron Giant.
All right. So I'm up for two. I'm gonna take.
I'm gonna take
Finding Nemo.
Great,
right?
Good one.
I'm gonna
good
take
pick.
Finding Nemo.
Great pick.
That's a good one.
And Little Mermaid.
I don't think that's
water based.
I know what Riley's doing. He's going for the older crowd because he knows the older crowd watches this. He's going for the older movies. I like what you're doing.
A sleeper right there.
I'm not gonna say it's a sleeper.
So is Davis? Davis is up next.
I'm up next. Oof, coming back right away.
Yep, right back to you. I know a lot of my picks aren't coming back to me, so I gotta get ready.
Yeah, I am going with Tarzan.
Ah, that's okay. All my list. My list is disintegrating
Tarzan.
Rapidly.
Yes, I know it is.
The adding Evan here is gonna fuck me. I'm gonna be reaching at my last picks.
Yeah, I gotta come
back. All right, so Hunter, you're up.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and say a little bit of Shrek 2.
You're gonna make him do it. You're gonna let him do it. He's gonna do it. You know he's gonna do it. All
right, so Hunter, you have Shrek 1 and Shrek 2 currently. That's a good pick.
That's a good pick.
That's
a good
pick.
Sequel.
Shrek
That's
2.
That's the best sequel. In
I think Shrek
it is the best thing. All right. Yeah. I agree.
It's pretty good.
All right.
Pretty good.
I'm throwing right hooks at with this one. It's going to be The Incredibles.
Ah! Oh,
that's a good pick.
You know what it is?
You know what it is.
My man Bob Carr.
27 Rings. You know what the fuck it is?
You know what the fuck it is.
All right. Evan, you're up for two picks.
Two picks.
Right
two picks.
Back to back.
Come on.
My first pick for the second round. I don't know if this is popular to you guys, but I'm going Space Jam.
I'll give it to him because it has a lot of
animated.
Yeah. Good pick.
Great pick.
That's a good pick.
That was like Hunter's Die Hard Christmas pick.
That's a great movie. That was such a sleeper.
That's a good
such
pick.
A great. Wow. Yeah. He's on fire right now.
That's a good pick. All right, and you're up
Evan's
for another one.
Episode for one episode, and he's better at podcasting than all of us.
We're giving
not even one episode. He's been in here for like 85 seconds.
He's been here for one bit.
Yeah.
One bit. All right.
You're up for another one.
And then my next pick. I always love this movie. I'm going Up.
Oh, fuck.
Up. Jeez, you took my pick.
Yeah.
You took my pick.
All right. Bad, Tim, you're up for one.
All right. My man, Aladdin.
Oh!
With Robin Williams, the genie.
That pissed off Hunter. Which one? One? The original?
Yeah.
I used to watch that movie after preschool.
The best
one.
That's a great movie. That's a
good pick.
That is a great movie.
Boys, I'm going to hit you with a sleeper.
Uh-huh.
I think I have to pick Shrek the Third.
Please.
Hey, producer Dave, it's not Shrek 3, it's Shrek the Third.
Yeah.
Get it right.
Make sure you get that correct.
I'm going with an obvious one here. Beauty and the Beast.
That's a good one.
Not as great as Shrek. I mean, you took my pick.
Gaston's
my
cool.
Pick.
Gaston's wicked cool.
Oh, dude, I got to make a decision between... Do you guys want to go five rounds?
No, we got to do
Less,
four.
Wait, the last time we did a movie-themed one, we did five.
But we didn't. We hadn't.
It was the Christmas movies one.
No, we didn't. Last time we did Plunge Picks, we only did four.
The last time we did. Yeah, that wasn't movie-themed. The last time we did movie-themed, we did five.
There's only
five.
Four Shrek movies. We're doing four rounds.
You got Puss in Boots.
We're doing five rounds.
All right, we're going five rounds. All right, I got Monsters, Inc.
Why did I think of that?
And Big Hero 6.
Great, good. Good.
Those are shit picks.
Thank you.
Big Hero 6, I thought you were going to fall for Monsters University.
I thought he was going Monsters University.
So. All right, Davis, you're up for your fourth pick. It's not your final pick, so save your sleeper for last.
I'm going with Toy Story 3.
Well, good pick.
Toy Story 3.
Good pick.
Made two Toy Stories. It's not original, but it's fine.
Well, Three Shreks isn't original either, but, you know, we're going to leave that alone. I'm going with Toy Story 3 because it was one of the movies where...
What was that fluffy orange pink guy's name?
Gumbo.
No. That's Laszlo.
Camp Laszlo.
It brought the memories back of a younger generation, and it almost made me cry at the end.
That's valid. Yeah, when they're in the furnace.
You can pick Toy Story 3.
Right on the porch. Kill me.
You can pick Toy Story 3. But I'm going to go with Shrek Forever.
Forever. After. Make sure emphasis on the four
Shrek
part.
Shrek Forever After.
Yeah. Shrek Forever After.
It's not like Batman
All right, Frat Boy Timmy, you're up. So, Tim, you're up for your fourth pick.
Oof, I got to get my man Lilo and Stitch out here.
Oh, okay.
That was a sleeper. I wasn't playing Stitch, dude.
Stitch is the next big rapper. Just shout out.
Lil Stitch.
All right, Evan, you're up for two picks. These are your last two picks.
Make them count.
Last two. I'm going with Wall-E.
Great. Okay.
Wall-E is a shit movie.
Wall-E is not a shit movie. It is amazing.
All right, movie. And the movie fucking avocado.
And
toast.
Evans over here is like, the movie I grew up watching, Frozen.
Evan is a youngin.
And then these are all this has got to be. I don't care what age you are.
Space Jam 2. You watch this movie.
The Lego Movie. The Lego Movie counts as animated.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
The Lego Movie is to me.
No, they actually shot that with real Lego.
I was waiting for him to be like the upcoming Space Jam 2 with LeBron James.
I was gonna choose Brother Bear, but
it's a good Brother Bear. Why would you say that out loud? Damn it, Evan! Why would you say that out loud?
All right, Timmy, last pick.
All right, I'm wrapping it up with my heritage. It's gonna be Hercules.
Okay. I love my the Greek god. Shout out Greek. Okay,
I love my Greek people.
Shout out Meg. We missed her on our hottest animated Megara cartoons.
Shout out to the two girls that I fucked. Hercules.
Fuck yeah, Herc.
Are you done? You pick your obvious pick.
Straight out of.
You want to take a guess at what it is?
Is it Puss in Boots?
It is Puss in Boots.
All right, so Hunter's final round pick, Puss in Boots.
Hunter might have the best team here.
I don't even know why I'm competing right now.
Why am I here?
No, but change it back to Puss in Botos. All right, Davis, last pick.
My last pick, Mulan.
Oh, that's yo, Mushu.
I'll Mushu. Make a man out of you.
Great movie.
Wait, what was the beginning of that?
Let's get down to business to defeat the Huns.
Do do do.
I don't know the rest of the words, but great movie. You know what? Honestly, I could pick these movies forever. Absolutely. There's so many good animated movies. All right,
I'm going to wrap it up with a sleeper. I've been sitting on this one.
I have a feeling that I know what it is.
Let's go six rounds.
No. What? Ready? Avatar. Not a single movie, not a single scene of that movie was real person. It was all CGI. It's all animated. Avatar, the blockbuster hit. Not Avatar the Last Airbender.
That's a straight up fucking lie.
Since we're giving Evan Space Jam, I'll give it to you.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
I'll give it to you.
Alright.
The blue Avatar.
Alright, so let's review. Evan, you have Toy Story 1, Space Jam, Up, Wall-E, and the Lego Movie. Tim, you have Lion King, The Incredibles, Aladdin. Damn, you got a good move. You got a good team. Lilo and Stitch and Hercules. Lilo and Stitch might bring you down in the polls. I'm going to be honest there.
That's a banger of a movie.
Elvis Presley banging out those tracks, dude.
Hunter, you have Shrek 1, yep. Shrek 2,
fact.
Shrek the third. Shrek Forever After. And Puss in Boots.
That is a team.
A spin-off of Shrek.
That's what I like to call a franchise,
a franchise team. That's a team that's going to play together long
Davis.
Term.
Davis.
Yeah, that's the paths of fucking animated movies.
It really is.
Davis, you got a good team. I think you're going to compete this week. You got the Iron Giant, Tarzan, Beauty and the Beast, Toy Story 3, and Mulan. And then wrapping it up, I have Finding Nemo, Little Mermaid, Monsters Inc., Big Hero 6, and Avatar: The Blue People version. Not
they should. Animated. It should be called, like, when they bring out Avatar 2, they should call it Avatar 2: The Blue People.
Yeah.
They should call it that.
Is that our next writers' room?
Writers' room. Avatar: The Blue People.
Blue Man Group: The Movie.
Is that just a remake of Avatar?
Yeah.
With just humans.
All right, so that'll wrap up this episode of The Plunge.
The Plunge.
Thanks for listening, guys.
Thank you for listening. Evan Clark, where can they find you on your socials?
That's T-H-E, Plunge Podcast.
You stole my... I don't even want to do
Evan,
it
Evan, where can they find you?
I'll just give them the Instagram.
The Instagram? Is that what the kids are calling these days?
You can find it at evan.clark10.
Give him a follow.
You can find those nice high school basketball photos.
Yes.
Tim, thank you for joining us, brother. It's been a joy. Where can they find you?
Happy to be here. I'm not going to put on my Instagram or anything because my girlfriend would fucking crucify me if I did that.
Shout out, Kowakala. All right. Thank you for coming on, Tim. That's the Greek Python. Greek Python. God. You can find him somewhere.
Actually, Hercules.
Yeah. Davis, where can they find you? Let's get a little personal.
No. Where can they find The Plunge?
No, let's get a little personal. Fuck you.
I'm going to get personal.
Where can they find you, Davis?
You can find me on Twitter, at Clavis Dark. That's C-L Avis Dark. You can find me on Instagram, at deviousdave_25. That's D. Evious Dave _25.
I don't like that both of you have the same Twitter of where it's just your first and last name switching letters.
Yep.
If you check out Davis on either platform, season 2 of Thoughts coming soon. It's
not. The hit YouTube series Thoughts.
Rip Thoughts.
Coming at you live, season 2.
I might have to make it now.
Davis in studio. Congrats on acting school, man. Yeah, we're very proud of you.
Thank you, boys.
We're excited to see where your journey leads.
I'm excited. I'm scared.
We're Team Davis.
Yeah.
We wouldn't start this shit with you if we didn't think you had it.
If you're not in Inception 2, you're not my friend.
I'll call Leo.
We
are going to have my brother on soon. My brother works in that business. We're just going to have the entire episode you asking him small questions about the film industry.
About the industry, because I'm going to need to know a lot of shit.
Yeah.
What's a camera?
Yeah. So, on a serious note, congratulations, Davis. We're super proud of you. We love you, man.
Love you too, man.
The future, we got 4 months till we have to decide on what happens there.
Yeah.
But we're proud of you. We're really just... It's awesome what you're doing, man.
Thank you. Thank you, my man.
And, like, I can't say how proud we are of you.
Thank you. It does mean a lot. I really know that means
we, that we means everyone has your support here.
Yeah, I know. I don't think I would have done it if it wasn't for you guys.
It was the comedy show. That's what it was.
It was
the
comedy show.
You stole all your jokes.
It was a comedy show where I stole some of my jokes. And speaking of comedy shows.
Season 2 coming soon.
Thought season 2 coming soon.
Check it out on YouTube. Hunter, where can they find you?
At my house.
All right, you can find Hunter at munter.harku.
Very original.
Is that my thing?
Or you can find Poostick19 on Instagram.
No.
It's just Hunter Marku, no period.
Okay. You can find me on Twitter at _Trudell_ on Instagram at true.dell. You can find us the podcast, on Twitter at Plunge Podcast. Davis, where can they find us on Instagram?
Do you want to find us on Instagram?
I don't think they do, but you should tell them anyway.
I'm going to tell them anyway because they're going to find us. You can find us on Instagram at The Plunge Podcast. That's T-H-E.
Plunge Podcast.
And while you're at it, check out the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
Yeah, we're coming with big shit. We have five shows. We're ready to roll. Those five shows, we said them already, but we're going to say them again. That is the Simmons and More podcast. That is it's at Simmons and More. You can find them. They're my favorite podcast to listen to on a weekly basis. Check them out. Adam is my fucking favorite person in the world.
He's a great
Bobby's
guy.
Also my second favorite person in the
world.
Like
he
gets,
Bobby.
He gets me real
him,
drunk
like
all
Bobby.
The time. So you can find them. Hashtag SamPC. Listen to their show. I swear. If you like us, you're going to like them way more.
if you're into nutrition and shite, you can hit up the Shit Happens When You Party Naked.
Shit Happens When You Party
with
Naked.
Jason and Christina Almy.
Oh!
Jason Almy.
Well, also, we're their kids.
We're their kids. If you want to hear more of my annoying voice, you can hear me this week on HTNOS on the hashtag No Offense Show. I went on the show this week. I told a lot of stories that I don't tell on here, so check that out. It's at HDNOS. You can find them on all platforms. But the hashtag No Offense Show, check them out. They're fucking great. And you can find the Hood Diner podcast, those fucking guys, the DJ Century, and the Homie Casual. I know all of you guys probably feel the same way. I had the most fun on any podcast we've ever recorded with Davis, the Homie Casual.
Producer Dave was, but legitimately one of the most fun experiences I've had.
So check out, I know, like, that episode is doing way more well than any podcast we've ever done, which I'm pumped about because it was my favorite one we've ever done. Go check out the Hood Diner. They come out with musicians from the Tucson area. They're just talking, they're just doing all their shit.
Their last episode was fucking sick.
Check them out. I swear, like, check out all the guys in the Inner Circle. We wouldn't fuck with these guys if they weren't putting out gold. Exactly. All right? And so check out these guys. Check out Sam PC. Check out HG Nos. Check out Shit Happens When You Party Naked. And check out the Hood Diner. Okay.
And to leave you with some wise words of a sizable man of Mexican stature. yummy.
All right. Thank you guys for listening. We'll talk to you next week. Tim, Evan, thank you guys for coming in. Producer Dave. Shout out. Fucking drunk Jerry in the corner. Step my money fast and go. Fast, fast. Fast like a Lambo. I be jumping off the stage, ho. Jumping, hey, hey. Crowd better save her. Crowd going, hey, hey. I can't believe we made it. This is what we made, man. This is what we think for. This is what we think, man. I can't believe we made it. This is a different thing. Hey, hell, seen a crowd going ape shit. Give me my check. Put some respect on my check. Pay me in equity. Pay me in equity. Watch me reverse out of dicks. He got a bad bitch. We living lavish, lavish. I get expensive fabrics. I got expensive habits. He wanna go with me. He likes to roll away. He wanna be with me. He wanna give me that vitamin D. Ice ornaments. Ice style ornaments. You ain't on of this. Don't think they on of this. But I'm a jet. Shut down Khalid. Give me the ball, give me the ball. Take a top shift. Call my girls and put them all on a spaceship. Hang one night with him, say I'll make you famous. Hey. Have you ever seen the stage going ape shit? Step my money back.